Now, Brady, this is the bit that really is going to do your head in, which I'm going to enjoy. I'm going to show you how light can be polarized by sheets of Polaroid. This is a sheet of Polaroid. It's a polyvinyl alcohol with iodine thrown in it. So in here, I'm not sure which way around it is, there are long molecules which are stretched out and they conduct along this direction, but they don't conduct that way. So that's what your Polaroid sunglasses are made of, stuff like this, which is built into it. So it reduces the glare, for example, off the road when you're driving along. So I put a sheet of Polaroid on top of this overhead projector, which produces light, and I put another sheet on top, polarized the same way, and they absorb a bit of light for each direction. But if I turn this top one round so that it is actually perpendicular to that original direction, you can see that you can kill off most of the light. So there's some turning backwards, and that's gone all the way around, and now I'm going back again, and you can see that it disappears. This is an offcut, a bit chopped off from the bottom of this to make it a square. And I can put it on top of these two, let me square them up, and you can't see it at all. I can put it underneath these two, and you still can't see it. But if I now slide it in between, you can see I'm rolling this up in the bottom corner and sliding it in between, you see you can see it. If I turn it round this way, it disappears. If I turn it round through 45 degrees, you can see something quite strong, and then turn it round a bit more and it disappears. It's magic. Now you see it, now you don't.
And do that
again. Now you see it, now you don't.
Amazing. What's going on?
Well, I find this absolutely fascinating. I couldn't believe this was going to work first, but I'll show you another set of equipment over here, which is some microwaves. This is a microwave generator, and it will generate waves which are polarized in one particular direction. And here is a receiver which will receive them. This wave has a wavelength which is 3 centimeters. Now, 3 centimeters is about yay long, whereas the light wave is 60,000 times smaller. So if I set up traveling waves, waves coming out of here and ending up over here and not being reflected, then it'll be a bit simpler. So I'll detect this by turning this on and getting a very nice big signal. Now I pick up a sheet of Polaroid. This is my sheet of Polaroid. It's just long conducting wires, the same as were in those sheets of Polaroid, but you couldn't see them there. So now I put it in this way round, and you see that you don't get any signal, and I turn it round, and I get a huge signal on the meter at the back. So there it is, nothing gets through, and I turn it round slowly, and you suddenly see the signal appear, and when it's perpendicular, I get a really big signal on the screen over there. What's happening here is that this is sending out waves which are oscillating with an electric field that goes up and down in this direction. And as the electric field hits this conducting wire, it induces a current in here, and because of the resistance of the wire, this causes the electromagnetic wave to be absorbed and heat to occur in the wire. So it gets totally absorbed by the wire. If I turn it round this way, well, now the electric field causes a little bit of current to go across there, but then it hits the other side of the wire and it doesn't dissipate any energy, it just gets stored there as a capacitance. So this does not absorb nearly as much energy, and so I get quite a large signal. And then I turn it round there and I get virtually nothing. Now I want to turn this around to show you that they're completely polarized oppositely. So if I have that vertically, this is now giving an electromagnetic wave which is oscillating vertically. This is now detecting only those waves which are going horizontally. It's just like those two sheets of Polaroid there. So I have a wave which is coming out and oscillating this way, and this one is not tuned to detect it at all, so I get no signal. Now I put the sheet of Polaroid in, and there's nothing there. If I turn it to 45 degrees, I get a huge signal going through. If I now turn it round to perpendicular, I get nothing. So I'll start off vertical, there's nothing there. I turn it round, I get a lovely big fat signal coming about 45 degrees, and then when it goes further round, it decays away to zero. So something is happening if I put this in at 45 degrees. I'm able to get waves which are oscillating this way to go through here and be detected by something which is detecting waves that way. I'm changing this signal, which is oscillating this way, to one that's oscillating that way. Otherwise, nothing would go through.
How have you done it?
Well, I haven't done it. It's this sheet of Polaroid that's done it. So if I imagine this is a wave which is coming out and has a vertical polarization like this, I can think of that as partly this angle, this side of the set square, plus that one. So as I put it in at this angle, if I think of this as being vertically polarized up and down, it's partly this and partly that. So as I put that in there, the bit which is running this way along this wire is killed off, and the bit which is running that way is now allowed to continue. So I have a state which is oscillating this way now, and this thing has managed to turn the plane of polarization of this wave from vertical to this direction. Now when this wave travels along this way, part of that is horizontal and part of that is vertical, and the horizontal part goes in. So I have a wave, I measure it, it changes the state of the system from being vertically polarized to one polarized in this direction. Once I've done that, this state can be detected by that. That's the interpretation of this whole experiment. And that's the classical interpretation in terms of electromagnetic waves. Now, Brady, this is the bit that really is going to do your head in, which I'm going to enjoy for the next few minutes. Out of this apparatus comes one photon. It is a photon which is oscillating this way. The chances of the photon going through here are 50-50. It can either be going this way or that way, and if I do it 45 degrees, they're equally probable. Then you get to this detector, and now it's coming out with that polarization. The chance of going this way are 50-50. So I'm going to only get a quarter of the signal going through if this really works. And that's the explanation why the signal's gone down. But notice now, as this photon comes through, I have to talk about probabilities of what goes on. It is not deterministic. And if you go through the mathematics, you'll find that these states, which I would like to represent using a ket, which is a triangle like this, and you put the symbol in as a triangle, that ket state changes from one to the other. And in between, I have a mixture of two different states, and it's the mixture of these two states that allows me to interpret this experiment. So it's much harder for poor old Brady to understand, because somehow quantum mechanics is biting him on the backside here, and he really doesn't like me to talk about mathematics at all. But without that, and without the idea of splitting this into two different states added together, I have no explanation for what's going on. So get your head round that, Brady.
I'll just edit that bit out. How do sunglasses work then?
Sunglasses work, well, I haven't got them, but I used to have clip-on Polaroids, and somehow if you're looking at light which is reflected off the road, for example, the light that's polarized in this direction is taken away, so you find that you have transverse polarization only, and if you get rid of that, you then reduce the glare off the roads completely, and so you don't get any nasty reflection off the roads. Or if you have a river and you're looking at the surface of a still river or a pond, it will get rid of the glare off the pond and you can actually see into the pond and see all the fishes below. The other reason they work is because it seems to attract all the girls if you're really cool, unlike me.